The Philippines launches a diplomatic protest against China after maneuvers by Chinese vessels led to collisions with Philippine ships, which are on a resupply mission to Ayungin Shoal. Foreign Affairs spokesperson Teresita Daza says Manila has also summoned Chinese Ambassador Wang Silian. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Monday morning called a command conference with all security authorities to discuss Beijing's latest violation. Defense Secretary Gilbert Teodoro called China's actions a blatant violation of international law.
China has no legal right or authority to conduct law enforcement operations in our territorial waters and in our exclusive economic zone. We are taking this incident seriously at the highest levels of government.
The Philippine Coast Guard is looking to complete its probe on China's actions within 5 days. But newly appointed Coast Guard Chief Ronnie Gavan insists the Chinese Coast Guard clearly violated collision regulations.
At this point, it is very, very clear that the two incidents are violations of collision regulations, the very regulation we Coast Guards are expected to enforce. So we find it unfortunate or ironic that a fellow Coast Guard will violate the law where they themselves are supposed to enforce.
China stands its ground in claiming ownership over Ayungin Shoal. Deputy Chief of Mission of the Chinese Embassy in the Philippines, Zhou Ziyong, conveyed the message to the Philippine Foreign Affairs Department on Monday. Zhou insisted the Philippines should seriously take China's grave concerns, stop making provocations at sea, and stop attacking and slandering China. The DFA challenged Beijing to act like a responsible global power.
We intend to clearly convey our position that we have every right under UNCLOS to carry out our legitimate activities in our maritime zones and that we do not accept any form of interference. China, as a major power, bears a heavier responsibility of contributing to peace and stability in the region.
The U.S. vowing its full support for the Philippines following the latest encounter between Manila and Beijing in the West Philippine Sea. The U.S. says it stands with the Philippines in the face of China's repeated harassment. It also called China's actions dangerous and unlawful. Washington also reaffirmed its commitment to defend Manila in case of any armed attack.
A Philippine think tank urges the government to activate its joint patrols with allies after the latest incident with China. Strat-based ADR Institute says the patrols with the U.S. and Australia, among others, will help Manila assert its rights in its waters. It also warns that the incident has implications on regional stability and global commerce. Strat-based says the events highlight the need for continued efforts to maintain stability and security in the West Philippine Sea. The Philippines' envoy to Lebanon says 59 Filipinos in Lebanon have requested for repatriation amid rising tensions between Israeli Defense Forces and the Hezbollah group. Ambassador Raymond Baratbat says they aim to repatriate these Filipinos by the first week of November. Baratbat also assures undocumented Filipinos in Lebanon they can still be repatriated as long as they secure immigration clearance from the Lebanese government. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department raised alert level 3 over Lebanon due to continuous fighting between Hezbollah and Israel in Lebanon's southern border.
As of now, the airport is open, but the number of flights actually are being fully booked because of the limited number of airlines flying out of Beirut. Mm-hmm. The Philippine Embassy is ready to provide assistance, of course, as soon as we get their repatriation forms, which we posted at the Philippine Embassy Facebook website. We will process them and then send them to the immigration for clearance. Most of the Filipinos here are undocumented. Of the 17,500 Filipinos, 10,000 are undocumented. They have come here illegally through various channels. There has been a deployment ban actually in Lebanon since 2006.
The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department disassociates itself from a controversial statement by Manila Special Envoy to China about killing Palestinian children. The DFA said Ambassador Teodoro Loxin Jr.'s statement was made in his strictly personal capacity. In a now-deleted tweet, Loxin said Palestinian children should be killed because they might grow up to let Hamas militants attack Israel. He later apologized to those who misconstrued his supposedly sarcastic statement. House lawmaker Ron Salo called the former Foreign Affairs Chief's opinion incomprehensible. He also said making the provocative personal opinion public was highly irresponsible. Lano del Sur Representative Zia Diong, meanwhile, said there's no room in Philippine society for the dangerous, bigoted, and Islamophobic rhetoric of Loxin's statement.
In other news, the Philippine Supreme Court junks the Senate's petition against officials from the Duterte administration. The petition stems from a memorandum by former President Rodrigo Duterte, which banned executive officials from attending Blue Ribbon Committee hearings about the Health Department's anomalous pandemic procurements. The Supreme Court believes the petition was prematurely filed and should have been resolved by the Senate. Former Senate President Tito Soto says the High Court's decision supports the Senate's independence as a co-equal branch of government, despite their denial of the petition.